सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमां अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वंदे गुरुपरंपरां। I welcome you all with my love and respects. I welcome all the devotees, disciples, samajis, satsangis who are sitting with us around the world. Today we are entering into a very important subject. I can call this as a Sutra for inner nuclear power. The last sutra, Patanjali was preparing us for a deep love and friendliness. The reason was, he is going to reveal some of the very powerful, very deep power related secrets. Secrets to experience the highest spiritual powers, the nuclear power, inner nuclear power. See, the risk with this great science is, just like nuclear power, it can be misused. See, if the nuclear power is used creatively, in no time, we will produce enough food for the whole world. We can produce all the clothes necessary for the whole world. We can create all the luxuries which are only now part of few people as a normal life to every human being. If this nuclear energy is used creatively, so much can be done. But unfortunately, unconsciousness of human being and the tendency of handful of people that all should not be equal to them. Please understand. Poverty is not because of any other reason except the ego and arrogance, the jealousy carried, cherished by just few, not even million, few thousand people in the planet Earth. The highest luxuries and comforts which they are having in their life should not become part of regular life, normal life for all human beings. That is the only reason why still poverty is in the planet Earth. Poverty cannot be eradicated by charity. For last thousands of years, thousands of charitable organizations are trying to remove poverty. No. Poverty can be eradicated only by conscious people getting into the power of making decisions. Just if we stop creating nuclear weapons and divert 1/10 of that energy in creative side, food, shelter, medical care, clothes, all the luxuries can become part of normal life, the decision makers need to respect consciousness. Human beings are not accidents. They are incidents happening in the planet Earth for a higher purpose. Just this one understanding, if it penetrates the decision makers, you think we don't have wealth? You think we don't have intelligence? No. We just don't have love, heart. It is lack of love responsible for poverty and suffering in the planet Earth, not lack of infrastructure. I tell you, humanity has reached the fulfillment of the outer infrastructure on January 1st, 1978. After that only I landed on the planet Earth. I am not making any stories or jokes. I tell you, humanity has reached whatever necessary for the outer world fulfillment. At least 2 cycles before my advent of birth, when I landed, I saw very clearly, now the humanity needs only one thing. It is inner awakening. When I assumed my body, I was very clearly planning, what is the real knowledge or the essence we need to carry? See, when you go for a trip, tour, you know the purpose and you pack up based on that. If it is a trekking, you base trekking shoes and all those things. If it is spiritual tourism, you pack up things necessary for that. For every tourism, you pack up things which is required. So before landing, I saw very clearly what really needs, what is the need of planet Earth for me to pack up. I saw very clearly it is love and consciousness, nothing else. Planet Earth does not need intelligence to create infrastructure. It needs little more consciousness and love in the heart of the decision makers. Just 2-3 things. The amount of energy we put on producing weapons to destroy others, in that only 1/10 of energy if we divert it to creativity. The amount of money we spend to protect our borders, 1/10 of that money if we decide to share with the neighboring countries, there will not be poverty in the neighboring countries and they will not try to penetrate your fence and they will not go on digging tunnels to come into your country. It is just little bit of consciousness on decision makers. Just a simple decision to make all the things available to us as a normal life for human beings. Just like atomic power can be used or misused, it can be used to produce whatever human beings need for all human beings on the planet Earth. Or it can be misused to destroy the whole planet Earth without human beings. Either it can be used to create whatever luxuries available on the planet Earth, or it can be used to destroy whatever is there in the planet Earth, the whole life can be wiped out. The concept of wealth, which encourages continuous creation, the concept of wealth which continuously encourages creation, not which leads human beings towards destruction, which leads human beings towards creation. One side, millions of human beings are dying because they don't have medical care. Other side, millions of human beings are killed because they wanted to retain their boundary. One side, millions are dying without food. Other side, millions are dying because of too much of eating. Starving and obesity, it is just consciousness which is needed, not the infrastructure. What is going on? I think I need to really create this question towards all the people who are decision making on the planet Earth. 6 billion people, at least 2 billion are working full time, and all our ancestors have created so much of intelligence and infrastructure, machineries and system. What are you guys are doing? Still, if you are not able to provide food, cloth, medical care and basic comforts for the 6 billion people, something is seriously wrong. The right way of using power. Patanjali is now going to talk about the great science of inner nuclear power. That is why he wants you to be prepared before initiating you into the power. It's a very powerful technique. Unless you prepare yourself with the last technique, means doing samyama and love, doing samyama and friendliness, you should not enter into this process. Please understand. If you enter into today's process without doing samyama and love and friendliness, without creating heart, friendliness, love in you, if you create power, it will be almost like a nuclear weapons being caught in the hands of terrorists. Very dangerous. The nuclear weapons are caught in the hands of terrorists. It is not only dangerous for themselves, dangerous for the whole world. Not only dangerous for the whole world, dangerous for themselves. Because the terrorist is already in the tendency of suicidal. And when a man is in that mood of suicidal, he will not bother to destroy the whole world. Because he thinks, I am not going to exist. Why others should exist? Let everybody die. Only a man who is interested in life, love, interested in living, The man who is interested in living, only only man who is interested in living and life should enter into this samyama. It is 131st sutra of Patanjali Yoga Sutras and third chapter, 25th verse. Subject is awaken your inner power, unleash your inner power. The sutra is Baleshu Asti Baladini. A very powerful sutra. Swami Vivekananda translates this sutra as through samyama on the strength of the elephant and other creatures, their respective strength comes to the yogi. Swami Prabhavananda translates as by making samyama of any kind of strength, such as that of the elephant, one obtains that strength. Swami Sachidananda translates as by samyama on the strength of the elephants and such other such animals, their strength is obtained. Before entering into the sutra, I wanted you to understand few basic truths. You are not as solid as you think. You are just liquid. Any shape your inner space takes, your inner essence also takes that same space. You are what you think you are. You are what you do samyama as you are. You are what you strongly believe you as you are. Whatever you contemplate in your inner space, consciously you express that in your life. You can see the living proof of this in so many great yogis' life in Vedic tradition. When Ramakrishna did samyama on the attitude of being a woman and serving Devi, he calls it Saki Bhava. He felt he is the servant of Devi, woman servant of Devi, maid of Devi. And the biography says, literally he had periods. All the physical expressions of women in his body. Same way, when he did samyama on Hanuman, visualizing himself as a monkey and servant of Rama, he says, and there are records, from his backbone the tail has started growing. Even tail started happening. And in the recent days, Swami Chinmoy, Sri Chinmoy, a powerful yogi, great Indian yogi, lived in New York. He can lift just like that elephants. He will literally lift elephants. He will make a platform, make elephant stand on it and lift it. I have seen in my life, my own master, mentor, Yogi Yoganandapuri, Raghupati Yogi, he will lift any size stones, any size rocks. I have seen with my eyes, not even using both hands. He will just roll in one hand. I really lost respect for the concept of weight after living around him. He'll just roll in one hand, huge rocks, taller than him. And just give one kick, they will roll. I still remember, in Arunachala Hill, there was a huge rock. At least 10 feet tall. Huge rock. For some reason, he was talking about that rock when we were sitting there. Then suddenly he said, come on, let us move this rock. I said, only we two are here, how can we move? He said, two are not needed, you just keep quiet. And he just moved it with one hand. I was shocked. But I thought maybe it was standing on a cliff and he just pushed it. Then I realized, after he showed the next step, he just lifted it and moved. Of course, difficult for normal, a logical mind to believe, but when you see, nothing can be done. Forget about all these extraordinary old yogis. See, in our ashram, everybody knows when the Kundalini is awakened, how you lift three times more your weight. The other day I was talking to a weight trainer. He said, maximum a man can lift only, a normal people who especially who don't practice this weightlifting and all, they can lift equivalent to their weight. That itself is lot of difficulty. But in our ashram, whoever is initiated now into yellow, at least we have 100 yogis in our ashram who has lifted three times more than their weight. When they get into samyama, three times more weight they are able to lift. I can say this samyama we already proved. We can now scientifically prove this samyama. How? When a person gets into that samyama and kundalini awakens, the extraordinary strength is expressed through the body. I can see normally, especially brahmacharinis who can't even lift more than 10-15 kg are lifting 150 kg. The kundalini, power of samyama. Before entering into the sutra, understand these three things. You are what you think you are. You are not solid as you think, you are liquid. So the change of shape of your inner space changes the personality of you. Third, samyama on anything expresses those qualities physically in your life, not just mentally, physically. This sutra is a powerful technique to achieve whatever you want. Patanjali is an intelligent guy. He is a very intelligent guy. That is why he first teaches you to be loving and compassionate consciousness. Then he gives you the technique to achieve whatever you want. Baleshu hasti baladini. By doing samyama on anything, like elephants, the powers of that can be gained. For example, if you do samyama on elephant, you being an elephant, you will just express that power, strength of elephant. If you do samyama, you being tiger, you will just express that strength of the tiger. If you just do samyama, you being lion, you will express that strength of that lion. Any samyama you do, you will express that extraordinary power. Ramakrishna calls it as bhava samadhi. In any bhava you enter, that bhava intensely expresses through you. Even your body changes. I'll do a study and prove. I'll make our yogis, brahmacharis and brahmacharinis who are whose kundalini is awakened, who are able to do samyama, I'll make them do samyama on elephant and prove this power of this samyama. If they are able to lift normally X amount of weight, I'll prove through this samyama they will be able to lift 10X, 10 times more weight. I'll prove, you'll see. If their weight is 50 kg, if they are able to lift only 50 kg with all effort, struggle, I'll make them do samyama. This samyama, and awaken the kundalini, and prove 10 times more weight they'll be able to lift. It's a powerful samyama process. Especially if your kundalini is awakened, if you are already levitating, understand? This samyama will immediately work on you. Only thing I want to tell you, first, do samyama on love, compassion, so that when you get this kind of deeper samyamas and express extraordinary powers, you will not misuse it. You will not abuse it. You will not destroy people using the inner powers. Inner powers are dangerous if you are not intelligent. Inner powers are really, really, really dangerous if you are not matured. samyama on anything will make that happen in you. Bhava, the attitude or visualization you enter becomes reality. Any bhava you enter into becomes your life. Any bhava you assume on yourself becomes living reality. That is why I constantly insist on all our ashramites, devotees, enter into the bhava of the leader, enter into the bhava of your master, do samyama on your master, you will imbibe all the qualities of the master. His intelligence, his walk, his clarity, his pure inner space, his strength will express in your being, his strong commitment and dedication. Or if you don't trust the master that much, at least do samyama on those qualities. If you don't think master is personification of those qualities, just directly do samyama on those qualities. But doing samyama on these great leadership qualities, but you should do samyama clearly defining. You cannot just say all good qualities, let it happen. No, that doesn't work. You should pick up specific clear instruction. Joy, always joy. Defined words, words which your mind takes cognizance, which it can grasp. Try this samyama today. Clear idea. First, pick up this one samyama. Meditate on elephant. Just completely center yourself on elephant, feeling you are elephant. You have all the strength of elephant. Your whole body is filled with the intense strength of elephant. And see, within 24 hours, how your whole strength level changes. I'll do a thorough study on this samyama. Even the muscle strength and power and bone strength changes. Now we have, after all, many machineries. Can study the bone strength and muscle strength. I'll make these yogis do the samyama on the elephant just for 1 week. Morning half an hour, evening half an hour. Awaken the kundalini and do the samyama. And I'll prove within a week how the bone strength and the muscle strength drastically increases. Anybody who has diseases related to strength, like arthritis, osteoporosis, all the diseases related to strength can be completely healed by this samyama. This samyama is specially for that. Now, enter into the samyama. I tell you, only once if you are initiated into samyama, kundalini awakening, it is like a master key. Anything you want, you can achieve. You can apply that science anywhere you want. Patanjali goes on giving you hundreds of samyamas. If you want that, go and open that door. That's it. If you want this, go and open that door. It's like 100 treasury rooms are there. You have a master key. Any treasure you want, go and open that. That's it. Close your eyes and sit. Intensely do samyama on elephant. Visualize you are a strong, powerful elephant. As Patanjali describes, Baleshu Hasti Baladini. Let the samyama and the strength of the elephant happen in all of you. Let you all experience intense physical strength and power, health of elephant, strong elephant. I bless you all. Let you all achieve, experience, live, express, radiate, and share the eternal bliss. Nityananda. Thank you.
Putting all my trust in you, 'cause you know it's best for me to lead a blissful life, a life with no more strife. I can't believe the things I do. A little time with you, nothing will compare. I know you will take care.
You're always showing us compassion. Your love is endless like an ocean. Nityananda, Nityananda. My life's become a meditation. Ever since we had a deep connection. Nityananda, Nityananda. Oh,
I'm